Hello friends, welcome to Data Science Lovers. In our last video, we learn about the transpose function. In this video, we will learn about unary operators in NumPy. Unary operators are those operators that require only one operand. As we are talking about the unary operators for NumPy, so there are functions here, and these functions can be applied row-wise or column-wise of a 2D or 3D array by setting an axis parameter. We use this axis parameter to consider row or columns in the NumPy arrays. Let's see some examples. First of all, we will import the NumPy library in this Jupyter notebook. Import NumPy as np. Suppose we have a simple 1D array. np.array. And here we will have some values. Okay, I will save this in variable A, and this is my 1D array A, which is having 4 values. Suppose we want to check the maximum value from this 1D array. So our variable name where our array is stored .max function. When I run this, it will show the maximum value from this array. So this is a unary operator. Similarly, we can show the minimum value using min function. This is also a unary operator. It is showing the minimum value. Similarly, we can check the sum of all the values of this 1D array using the sum function like this. It will show the sum of all these 4 values. Now we will use the unary operators on a 2D array. Suppose I have a 2D array. np.array 1, 12, 55 and like this 53, 90 and 2. I will save this in variable b. This is my 2D array. When I print this, it will look like this. It has 2 rows and 3 columns. Now if I want to use the max function on this 2D array, then b.max, then it is showing the largest, or you can say maximum value from all values. Okay, it is considering the rows as well as column here. Now suppose I pass the parameter inside this max function, the axis parameter that we were talking about, axis equal to 1. When I run this, it will show the output like this. It is showing the maximum value from each row. From first row, the maximum value is 56, and from second row, the maximum value is 90. Now we can also use on axis equal to 0, b.max, and this time we will pass our parameter axis equal to 0. When I run this, it will show the maximum value from each column. From first column, maximum value is 53, from second 90, and from third column, the maximum value is 56. Similarly, we can check the minimum value from this 2D array using min function. When I run this b.min, it will show the minimum value, and it will consider both rows and 3 columns. And we can use the axis parameter in min function also. Axis equal to 1. When I write, then it will show the minimum value from each row. From first row, the output is 1, and for second row, the output is 2. Similarly, we can use axis equal to 0. Then it will show the minimum value from each column. 1, 23 and 2 are the outputs. We can also use the sum function on this 2D array, b.sum, and it will show the sum of all values of this 2D array. We can use the sum function axis wise also. B.sum axis equal to 1. When I run this, it will show 80 and 145. Since we passed here axis equal to 1, so it will work row wise. And for the first row, it will show the sum of all 3 values. It is showing 80. Similarly, for second row, the sum of these 3 values is 145. And we can use sub function with axis equal to 0 also. It will show the sum of all 3 columns values. 1 plus 53, it is showing 54, and second is 113 and 58. Okay, Now we will use the unary operators on a 3D array. First of all, we will create a 3D array. C equal to np dot. This time we will use the arrange function from NumPy library. Arrange 18. It will show 18 values from 0 to 17. And if we print C now, it will show the output like this. As we have to use a 3D array, I will reshape this in the form of a 3x3. And we will use two matrix here and three rows and three columns. Now, when I print C, it will show the output like this. Now it is a 3D array. First of all, we will use the max function on this array and it is showing 17. 17 is the maximum value in all these values, in both matrix and in all rows and all columns. When we use min function, it will show the minimum value. Minimum value is 0, as you can see. If we use max and minimum function on our axis like this, axis equal to 1. If I run this, it will show the output like this. It will show the row with maximum values from each matrix. So it is showing two rows. First row from first matrix, second row from second matrix. Similarly, we can use minimum function. This time we will use minimum function on axis 0. It will show output this. Here the comparison for the minimum value is done between the columns of these two matrix. As you can see, all three columns of first matrix are smaller as compared to the all three columns of the second matrix. So in the output it is showing this. The first column values are smaller than the first column values of second matrix. Similarly, the second column values are smaller than the second column values of second matrix, and the third column values are smaller as compared to the third column values of the second matrix. Now we can also use the sum function. C dot sum. It will show the sum of all the values from this 3D array. You can use sum on axis 1 as well as on axis 0. So that's all for this video. In our next video, we will talk about the VStack and HStack in the NumPy library. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos on NumPy as well as on Pandas Matplotlib.